This is one of the most busy areas of MISB Bocconi. People actually fight to be on this table. It might not seem so right now because the fight has been shifted elsewhere. Let me take you there.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. I invite you to the Battle of Wits. On the right-hand corner, I have Adhiraj Sharma. A self-proclaimed stud, nobody else feels so. On the left-hand corner, I have Samrat Paul.
Samrat, I love you.
Who thinks he's really good at TT, but doesn't even know how to hold a racket? What? How dumb. Anyway, the topic in contention today is whether e-commerce is a bubble. Adhiraj here thinks e-commerce is here to stay, whereas Samrat thinks it's a bubble that's going to pop. So here, I leave the floor open to their discussion.
Tell me something. How can you think that e-commerce is a bubble which is about to burst?
You yourself are an e-commerce loyal person. You don't go to the mall anymore.
E-commerce is driven by statistics, and the statistics are e-commerce is making humongous losses. How do you justify that?
See, I understand, but every industry goes through stagnation. Manufacturing did, retail did.
So is e-commerce. That does not mean that you vindicate that it is a bubble that's about to burst.
Oh, so you're telling me that the obscene valuation of these e-commerce companies is just? Seriously? I don't think so. The private equity players and the venture capitalists have become much smarter. So earlier, which they had valued, given a valuation to the company, they are devaluating the same company. Just imagine, a $5 million company being valued at $50 million.
And then there is always the case of losses that these huge e-commerce companies are suffering right now.
But have you stopped to consider why they are incurring these losses? To gain market share, to expand their businesses.
Let's talk about expanding market share. Let me tell you some facts. The companies, big e-commerce companies, have been making 3 to 5 times the losses than they made in the previous years. Do you think they are making these losses at expense of gaining market share? Are you serious? No, man.
The reason I think industry is facing such losses is because of the hefty discounts being provided on merchandise, products, services.
They offer these discounts because they don't want their competitors to have a monopoly, like how there are major players in the States or in China.
I disagree. The customer acquisition cost lies between 250 rupees to 1000 rupees per customer. Is that sustainable? The big e-commerce companies are only chasing valuations. They are not having a sustainable business model.
But have you ever stopped to consider why these businesses are really in demand? A person like you or me would not want to get stuck in the traffic for 3 hours in these rains. And then finally, when you reach that place, you don't have a fixed parking spot and all you've got to do is pick up a damn shirt. The lack of physical infrastructure is exactly what e-commerce is thriving on.
Okay, let's consider that we accept his point. The whole point is, if you're having so much successful, loyal customers, why are you laying off 300 to 400 employees? Why are big major companies laying off people? Okay, cost cutting may be dealt in two ways. One is making operations efficient, leaner. The other is cost cutting through laying off people. Tell me, is it ethical to lay off people?
You're only considering the negative side of this, where you say that 300 to 400 people are getting laid off.
Of course.
But are you also considering the fact that there are job opportunities being created? Say more than 30 to 40,000 job opportunities are being created. You or me, once we graduate from here, may work in that industry.
Even though it might be your dream company, the day is not far away that they ask you to just pack your bags and ask you to get lost. And the main reason is lack of funding.
If that was the case, then why would conglomerates with diversified businesses invest into this industry right now?
Oh, believe me, that doesn't work. So what is their journey? They'll provide discounts, they'll provide clearance sales, they'll provide end of season sales, then what?
As soon as the war gonna end, the traditional retail is gonna pick up again. Yeah. Also, as the customer loyalty in that case.
So discounts may shrink, new models may appear, new niches may also be discovered, and not all the commodities that can be traded on the e-commerce platform are actually being traded there.
With disposable time and expandable disposable income, e-commerce is here to stay.
Oh no. With the increasing number of customers, you'll incur even more losses because the cost for those customers will be higher.
But if that was really the case, then a major industry player would not invest in the last mile delivery.
Yeah man, I ordered a phone yesterday and I got it delivered today. I'm never gonna stop using e-commerce.
That is a classic case of another customer being added to the bandwagon and you incurring more losses, the e-commerce company.
Well said.
But okay, hold up. If you really wanted to talk about that, just think about this now. Only 40% is of India is internet penetrated. There is a lot of scope right now.
Yes, even though the penetration is increasing, but the selling in two-tier and three-tier cities is difficult, which is only adding up to the cost. So would e-commerce industry sustain?
Second and third-tier cities do want these major brands that they do not have access to as of now. And the only way they will have access to such brands is through e-commerce. Alright, people will pay any amount they have to, even if they don't get discounts, to just get their hands on these merchandises.
Yeah, in fact, even urban India is getting attracted to all the mass hybrid products that e-commerce companies have to offer. So this is all one-stop solution, right? So e-commerce is a one-stop solution.
See. I'm not saying that e-commerce is going to fade out. It's not the case. All I'm saying is that e-commerce companies will get more saner valuations. They'll be more realistic. The growth will be realistic instead of exponential. That is the whole point.
See, the only thing that I can say right now is people are just going to get lazier and busier. And that's exactly what e-commerce thrives on. So I think it's going to stay.
I agree to disagree.
So that was the battle of wits between Samrat, who feels that e-commerce has obscene valuations and should be reduced to senior, realistic growth levels, whereas Adhirath feels that it is an industry that is here to stay regardless of how it grows. And that's that. Thank you.